Welcome to Ground Control RC. The item for review today is the FlyBear SU-35. It is the, let's see here, I believe it's the FX-820. Yeah, the FX-820. It comes with this very large controller compared to the other FlyBear planes that I have flown. Let me pull out of here a little bit so you can see what I'm doing. And it takes 3 AA batteries to power the transmitter. So it comes with a transmitter. The plane does require a minor amount of assembly. The vertical stabilizers are not attached. I attached those with some foam tack glue, but you could use a little bit of hot glue or some other foam safe glue. It comes with this nice carrying box. It comes with a little USB charger for the battery. It does take a lossy connector. It comes with the landing gear, and it comes with two spare props. This is a little two-channel plane, so you have throttle and you have yaw, and it uses two brushed motors to provide yaw. You know, it'll speed one motor up, slow the other one down. It comes with this little tiny landing gear. I believe that in the specs it states that this plane weighs 38 grams. So let's go ahead and put this thing on the scale here in a minute and see actually how much it weighs, if it actually weighs 38 grams. It does have an on-off switch, which I like, and it has a little battery compartment so you can switch out the battery. It comes with a one cell 220 milliamp LiPo. And as it happened, I have two additional 220 milliamp one cell LiPos with a lossy connector. It comes with a little manual that is in English and Chinese. And let me grab one of the batteries real quick. Okay, so this is the little stock lossy battery that came with the plane. So I'm going to fly it without the landing gear. The area that I have to fly in, it'll be a lot less damaging on the plane if I just belly land it rather than try to land it out there with that landing gear. So let me go ahead and the other thing that kind of gives me pause about this transmitter, all you have is, you know, you have throttle and you have yaw control. This big red button basically is your power button. It has a dial here for trim, but it's not functional. It's so, you know, it's made as part of the case. Now, on the other two FlyBear planes that I reviewed, one was the FlyBear Micro Red Baron Bi-Plane, and I love that little plane. So far, it's the best trainer plane I've found for little kids. And then I also reviewed their F-16, which the one I had just was terrible. It didn't fly very well. But both of those planes had a functional dial so that you could set the trim on the plane in case you had one motor that was turning faster than the other one. This one does not have a trim dial. So, you know, that kind of gives me pause. Because what are the chances that these two brushed motors are going to be synced up on RPM? You know what I mean? So, I read the manual, and what they say in the manual is if it flies and it's tail heavy, then bend the end of the elevon down, to the elevator down, and if it yaws to the left or to the right, when you're not given any input, then it states to bend the ends of the vertical stabilizers. And I thought, and I don't know why they did that. Why they didn't just put a trim tab, a trim dial on the transmitter is beyond my understanding, but I want to see how much the plane weighs with the landing gear and with the LiPo. Okay, so, and I'll bring the camera in closer so you can see it, but I want to put the landing gear on there. That's 1 gram. And then the LiPo brings it up to 8.4 grams. Move the transmitter out of the way and get the plane balanced on here. Okay, so the plane is balanced on there, and let me see if I can bring this in so that you can see the digital readout on the scale. I don't know if I can or not. Maybe you can see that. Let's see if I can focus it in here. Yeah, so the plane with the battery and the landing gear weighs 44.82 grams is what it's showing right now. And I believe in the documentation it states that it's 38 grams. So that's quite a bit off from what the specs state for the weight of this plane. But no way to trim it except for actually moving the control surfaces. If it's like their other planes, it's probably going to be a little bit tail heavy. So I will take a penny or a dime or something with me to attach to the nose if it turns out that it's tail heavy. But it's a cool looking plane, and I've been waiting. This thing has been out of stock forever, so I was waiting a long time to be able to get one of these to review. So let's go ahead and pack it up, and I'll see you out the field. We'll see how well this plane flies. See you out there. Okay, we have the FlyBear FX-820 SU-35 two-channel microjet. We've got it bound up. Let's throw it in the wind and see what it does. We've got wind out here at 2 to 5 miles an hour. Sure wants to climb. Looks like most of the fly bears that I have come across, it looks like it's a little bit tail heavy. See if I can bring it down a little bit. Really wants to climb, especially into the wind, because like I said, we are. Look at that, just floating. 2 to 5 miles an hour wind, and it is just floating up there. I'll try to keep it out of the sun as best I can, but it is already flying, I think, better than the F-16 did. But I'm going to bring it back in here. I'm going to do a couple of circuits, and I'm going to bring it back in. And you definitely want to throttle it up when you're turning. I'm going to bring it back in and then put a little bit of nose weight on it. Look at that. It just floats. Look at that. That is cool. Okay. Alright, so I'm going to put a little bit of nose weight on this guy to make it fly a little bit better, but if that's an indication, this thing's flying a lot better than the F-16 ever did. So, yeah, that's pretty cool. Alright, so I'm going to pause it here and put a little nose weight on it, and then we'll see how it flies with a little more nose weight. Okay, so I used a little bit of painter's tape, and I taped a penny underneath the nose. So let's see if that does any good. It's really climbing. But it definitely doesn't have the huge nose up attitude that it had before. So let's see if we can float it in here again. Yeah. So what I did was I taped a penny to the nose, and that seemed to help a lot. I know it's probably hard to see this little guy on video. Let's see if I can bring it in here a little closer. The wind's kicking up again. Yeah. That is not a bad flying plane at all once you put a little nose weight on it. But it does really want to climb when you come into the wind. And I'm flying in a 2 to 5 mile an hour wind this morning. Pretty neat, huh? Yeah, I have to say, you know, for a little two-channel plane, it's pretty fun.
I would say that with a little nose weight, this little guy flies just as well, or just about as well, as that Red Baron airplane. Red Baron biplane. Now, I think it's a little bit faster flying than the little biplane. The biplane, I think, has a little more lift than this one does, so you can fly it a little bit slower. So I still think that the Red Baron is probably, check that out, pretty neat. I think the Red Baron airplane is probably a better trainer for a little kid, but this might make a good second airplane for a child once they get used to flying the little Red Baron, because I think it flies a little bit faster, but pretty darn neat, huh? Yeah, I'm liking it. I think that I would definitely buy this one again. Now let's turn back over this way, slow down a little bit again. Into the wind. Yeah, pretty cool. You want to be careful that you don't make too abrupt, you're not too abrupt on the turns, you know, kind of give it a little nudge. And then let off and give it a little nudge again. And make sure you're increasing the throttle when you're turning, because, you know, it has to slow the motor down, so to make that turn. Speed one motor up and slow one down. So just kind of give it a nudge. And I don't know, I'm probably about 50 meters out there right now, 60 meters out there. But I'm just giving it a little nudge to the left. Get it to turn. And I'm coming into the wind, so I'm letting off of the throttle quite a bit again. Isn't that neat? Little nudge. Little nudge. Little nudge. Throttle up, little nudge. Okay, get it coming back over toward me. Yeah, that's a pretty nice flying little two-channel airplane. I'm pretty impressed with it. I think the SU-35, I think that it has more wing area than the F-16 had, and I think that might be the difference as to why this one flies quite a bit better, I think, than the F-16 did. The F-16, you know, I would just nudge it around to get it to turn, and it would just nosedive. And I just could not get the weight, you know, the additional nose weight, no matter where I put it, I could not get that plane to... Oops! Okay, I didn't throttle up enough on that. And we might be to the end of our battery anyway. But how much fun is that? That's a blast. Oh, my little battery bay popped open. But yeah, I would definitely buy this one again. This is a pretty good flying little airplane, and I don't have the landing gear on it. You know, as you can see, the area around me is way too rough for a little tiny land gear on this thing. But so I just belly land it. But yeah, that's pretty neat. And like I said, I was flying in 2 to 5 mile an hour wind, and it seemed to do just fine. You know, for a plane this size and this weight, flying in a 2 to 5 mile an hour wind, that did a pretty darn good job. So I'm pretty impressed with it. I give it a big thumbs up. I'll see you back at the shop.
Okay, so what did you guys think of this little plane? I thought this was a pretty excellent flying little two-channel plane. Almost as good as the FlyBear Red Baron biplane. Now, after watching the video, because I flew this twice, I took 3 battery packs with me, but my third battery, the spare batteries that I used were pretty old batteries, and the third battery that I tried to fly with, it just wasn't up to speed. So I will have a link to this in the show notes. We get a commission off of those sales through our links, and it helps us buy additional products to review. So if you would use that link, it doesn't cost you anything. Last time I checked this, which I think was yesterday, this was still on sale. I bought it from RC Moment, and it was still on sale for $24 with free shipping. So yeah, I'm definitely going to get more than $24 worth of fun out of this. So I think when I take it back out, I'm going to try to find a little steel washer that is just slightly lighter than a penny, maybe 0.2 grams, 0.3 grams, just to see if that's a better weight. The penny worked out great. Whichever one works the best, I will update that information in one of our Pilot's Lounge videos. I'm going to be creating another one of those pretty soon on product updates and what we've got coming down the pipeline. So I had a second flight on this, and after I had a little practice with the maiden flight, the second flight was a lot better than the maiden flight. That's going to be posted on our Patreon site, and it will be freely viewable. So definitely check that video out. You'll see a little better flight footage of this plane in that video than you will in the maiden flight. And so for the money, I wouldn't hesitate to buy this again. And I had been waiting a long time. This had been out of stock forever. I'd been waiting a long time for this to become available again so I could review it, because I do like these little FlyBear two-channel planes, and I had a lot of fun flying it. So go out and get one, and check out our Patreon site. Please give a thumbs up if you like the video. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe. And I will see you in the air.